Hi guys, wait till you hear the explanation of Friday's video. So we had a collective video. I have more understanding of that now. It is amazing how it all fits together. We are talking about the principles of the 5D realm and what ideas and foundations we are building the new earth on. So if you want to know where we're heading, please stay tuned. Please listen to these ideas and concepts. It is literally magical to me how these things come together. So we ended Friday's video with the dreamer, who's the Knight of Mirrors. And I called him Joseph, and the coat of many colors is what I called this guy at the end of the video. The coat of many colors. It is also the Phoenix Rising. He's got a rainbow. He's got a coat of many colors. It turns out that Joseph, I went to look it up in the Bible, of course, and the coat of many colors describes perfectly what we have been talking about. You are, should be amazed. At least I was. Okay, here we go, you guys. First of all, Israel, who's Jacob, loved Joseph more than all his children because he was the son of his old age. You guys, this is a perfect representation, and no wonder that the parent came through in Friday's video, okay? So Joseph is the child of Jacob, Israel, who is born of Jacob when Jacob is super old, mature, and ripe. This is a picture of humanity today. Humanity is reaching an age of evolution, an age of maturity, an age of ripeness. We are ripe to receive new information and evolve the mind and become enlightened beings. Now, Joseph is born when Jacob is ripe, okay? He made him a coat of many colors. A coat of many colors. The dreamer, the Knight of Mirrors, a coat of many colors. Look at what this means. And it's everything we've been talking about. The coat, of course, you guys, is a tunic, an undergarment. We have been talking about how your habits are a habit. And a habit is an outer cloak that nuns wear. Your customs are a costume. They become the character you wear. Your traditions, your customs, and your habits become your character. You put them on as a cloak and you wear them as your coat. Okay? Joseph is new. He's getting a new coat, new customs, new habits, new traditions. His is going to be a coat of many colors. We talked about how when humanity was younger and dumber, not evolved, not mature, and not ripened, the coat was a coat that was muted. It didn't have many colors because man has been ruled by other men, by government, by rules, by laws, by standards, by conditions, by expectations of other humans. We all expect humanity to act the same way, put on the same fashionable clothes, do the same things, go to school, go to college, get a job for 40 years, security in that way, get a wife for 50 years, and all look the same. We expect society to be successful. You have to have the perfect house, the perfect marriage, the perfect career. Everybody looks the same. The perfect education. It's not a coat of many colors. It is a coat that is muted, dull, and gray. And everybody fits into that box. We're trying to shove everybody into the box. Coat, at its root, means shoulder, This is the word coat, which is the costume that you wear. It means shoulder blade, side slope, slope of a mountain, and supports. A coat of many colors. This is a man bowing down his head. He's wearing a halo of many colors. His shoulder blades are the slopes of the mountain. And in his spine, he has had a darkness, a pit, a gulf, an opening, a gaping. This is Joseph in his coat of many colors. He's putting on a cover. A cover. A covering. It turns out that the rainbow cover, this is his cover. The rainbow cover is the correct cover. We don't want the dull, muted covering that makes us conform. Okay, let's go to the word. I can't believe we've been drawing the coat of many colors all along, you guys. Coat of many colors. Let's go to colors. Colors means palm and sole of your foot. You guys are not going to believe this one. I made a video several years ago, and I'll link it below, okay? Let me remember to link it. And it was all about the palm of the hand. So in that video, we learned what Sheol, the word of hell, the word hell, the word grave in the Bible means. And it means an open chasm, an open pit, a pit of hell, an abyss. Do you see how this mimics the pit? Here's a pit. Your palm of your hand has the hollow in it. There's a hollow space. It is literally the same idea as a chasm. I wish I could show you better. Okay? So your open palm has been a chasm. It's been a pit. Sheol, I will show you, means to... Sheol. Here's the word Sheol. Okay? The root idea is to ask, inquire, beg, borrow. It's to ask a favor. It's to beg, to practice beggary. It literally, to keep your hands like this, literally is the word beg. Fill my hand, please. Ask a loan is another definition. Please, please give unto me. Okay. When we were young and unevolved, our palms were open. We were actually in the pit, in the chasm, in the hollow of Sheol. This is because, okay, trust me, and we're going to go on with Joseph's story. So early humanity has their palms open. They are beggars, servants to the system, subject to the rules, standards, laws, and conditions. And who fills their hands is everybody else who tells them how to behave. No, if you want to be a good person, do this. Look this way. And they're filling your hands with ideas, concepts, beliefs. If you want to be good enough, follow me, they say. And so they fill your hands with all of their ideas, all of their expectations, all of their conditions. Okay. They fill the palm of your hand. They're also filling your soul. Yes, the sole of your foot, as you just saw in the definition, but also the palm of your hand and your soul, S-O-U-L. They are filling your soul. Okay? With their ideas. And you, individually, become muted. Not a coat of many colors, a shade of gray. Okay, so what happens to Joseph? Joseph eventually is sold into slavery by his brothers because when all of Joseph's brothers hear that Jacob loved him more than all of them and gave him this beautiful coat of many colors, they hated Joseph and could not speak peaceably unto him. So it has been in society up until this point. If you look different and act different and don't conform, don't fit into society's box, people gossip about you, they hate you, they talk about you, they slander you with their tongue. And in doing so, they kill your spirit. You become muted and gray, a shade, a shadow, not the rainbow, a shade, a shadow of who you truly are. And he said unto them, Joseph says to his brothers, hear, I pray you, this dream which I have dreamed. Joseph the dreamer. Joseph the dreamer. For behold, Joseph says, in my dream, we were binding sheaves in the field. And lo, my sheaf arose and also stood upright. And behold, your sheaves stood round about and made obeisance is different, but it means this. Obeisance to my sheaf. So Joseph is telling his brothers that they're all going to bow down to his sheaf. Okay. Binding. Look at what binding means. They were binding wheat in the field, you guys. Binding wheat in the field. And to bind is to be dumb, muted, dumb, muted, muted. Muted, muted colors, muted shades, not vibrant, okay? Oh, I should have shown you. Silence. Now, why is it bad to be put to silence? Because, you guys, God is word. The word is God. So if you are able to speak, you can be a God. If you are put silent, and this is only symbolic, there are many ways to speak a language, one of them through your hands, and that's perfectly fine. This is a concept. If you can't speak, you cannot be a God. If you are put silent, you also, if your body isn't making a tune, if you are silent, isn't making a tone, it can't be in pitch. It can't be in tune. It can't be in harmony with God's word, which simply means the universe. The strings, the bridge. The bridge of music, the pitch, the atonement. Okay, so in the field, here's your sheaf, and lo, my sheaf arose and stood upright. Okay, guys, this is where I started to get the understanding of what was going on here. His sheaf arose. What does sheave mean? And stood upright, you guys. Stood upright. Sheave. disc. Disc. And down here, it's the other disc right here. Disc, okay? This is stood upright, and disc, you can start thinking about the spine. Growing a spine is evolving from the worm, the fish, the reptile, into the human being, standing upright, your spine. Okay, you guys, when you had an open hand, the spine is the rod, and the rod is a ruler. It's a measuring stick, a ruler. The rules, conditions, standards, and expectations of society would come down on your open hand and impress upon you like a stamp. Stamp you with their impressions, with an imprint. Nope, you are branded by my idea. Here, have blonde hair and blue eyes, or you're not good enough. There's my impression. And you take that in, and it imprints upon you and impresses you. It starts to form your brand, which, by the way, is your name, which means your character, everything you stand for, your brand. It starts to brand you and tattoo you and make your costume, your coat, reflect them. You don't want your coat to reflect them, have all of their markings on it. This is the mark of the beast of old. The mark of the beast is allowing anybody to write upon you their stamp, their mark. Okay? It's pestle and mortar. The rod, the ruler, the expectations and conditions of other people coming down. Pestle and mortar. This is what it was. Okay. When they bowed down to Joseph, their sheaves bowed down to Joseph. The language under all of this was the word to lay flat, to lay prostrate, to lay flat on the ground. All of his brothers bowed down to him, you guys. The word here in the definition is prone. Prone. Okay? So they were bowing down to Joseph in Joseph's dream. What happens in the word prone? I'm in the word prone. What happens? Having the palm downward. Okay, here we go. This is being in Sheol, asking of everybody else their opinion. What should I do? What should I be? How should I act? How do you want me to perform? Listening to society's rules, other people's standards. This is how you are, okay? When you get finally mature and you ripen, you stop listening to other people's opinions of you. In fact, what happens is you close, you cover, the chest. When you are lying on your back, your belly is exposed. And they are impressing on the soft, fleshy parts of your underbelly. You come now with the covering to protect yourself. It's the word Sheol, shield, shell, and soul. no longer in Sheol, because the shell has been completed. Your shield has been completed. Your soul has been completed, covered. What is the covering? I'm going to take you there because you have to see it for yourself because it's amazing. Let's see if we can find it. The cover is let me show you what this is. Okay, hold on. When you were in the abyss, Sheol, the pit, the hollow of the hand. This was your ship. Your ship was taking on water all the time. The rocking motion of the rod, the pestle, the rules, rocked your ship back and forth. You had no cover for it, and so you were subject to take on water. This is the mortar and pestle. This is your ship without sail, okay? Now, your ship is being covered. Your ship is being covered. It can no longer take on water, Noah. It's being covered, your soul. The shell is being covered. The pearl is safe inside. What used to happen when you had no covering on your ark, your sailboat, your ship, when you had no covering on your ark, what happened is you would gather up some treasure and the birds of prey would come and take it away from you. You would fill up in hell your hands and it would leak out the bottom, spill over the sides. And the birds of prey were open to come and take the treasure out of your chest. My friends on my membership, they could take the deposit out of the embankment. All along, you've been making deposits in your bank. Bank, this is the bank of the river, the embankment. The birds of prey could come and take out your treasure because you had no covering on it. Also, this is the mercy seat, your Ark of the Covenant. Ark of the Covenant, for those of you who know the Bible, is your treasure chest. It had no covering on it. What's the covering? It's the mercy seat. The mercy seat is the covering over your ark. Mercy seat, the place of atonement. What's atonement? It's tune, it's pitch, it's no more muted colors, but sharp colors, sharpened. No more flat notes, sharpened notes. Okay, more clear. Cover. To cover, purge, make atonement, make reconciliation, cover over with pitch. This is the mercy seat. This is your covering for those of you who know the Bible and Jesus Christ. Okay? So all of this is changing now. Now you have a cover over your bank. The pearl is safe. This, once you put the cover on your ship, it becomes a pontoon. Trust me, it's in the language. Pontoon. Pontoon is a balloon. Pontoon is something that floats. And pontoon is your camel. I swear to you, you can look it up yourself. Pontoon is a camel. Pontoon boat and camel in the desert. Camel, it's your hump. It's your hump, your camel. Now, your camel goes through the eye of the needle. It's your spine. It goes through the eye of the needle instead of getting stamped, picked, pinned, opinion by the eye, by the needle. Instead of getting the pinned by the opinion of the pin, you now go through the eye of the needle. The eye of the needle is your spine. Your spine is now rainbow colored because you've turned on all of your chakras. You are now able to, the eye of the storm is spinning. It's spinning. A beautiful coat of many colors. A coat of many colors. Going through the eye. Okay. So, this, you guys, is also a shell is a shield. A shell is shellac. It literally, you will have to trust me, is a turtle shell. So, at one time, the turtle was on his belly. His belly was exposed. He was able to be pierced through by all the pins, opinions of other people. He was a pin cushion, the soft flesh of his belly. Now you turn the shell over, and you are not able to be pierced by the judgments of others. Not only that, you become a merciful person, God, sitting in the throne. The throne that you sit in is the mercy seat. It has no opinion about what other people are doing. It all is beautiful rainbow colored. It is wonderful to see the sharp tones of other people's colors. You love it. It is your eyeball of light, multiple colors of light. This relates to astrology, and it's because the turtle on his back, when he was able to be pierced by the rod, imprinted by the stamp, the mark of the beast, that's our south node. It's the south node. Okay, in your astrology chart, you're going to be able to find south and north nodes. The south node is something that you want to heal and leave in the past. It is in the past. To have your belly exposed is in the past. You are putting on a coat of many colors. It's a shield. You are flipping the turtle shell over. The hand is no longer asking and begging and borrowing from other people. You now have your own ideas. You now, it's like you're clamping this lid shut and all this radiance comes out of it. Okay? The north node is this one, and it is where we are headed. It's your lot. It's your destiny. It's your fate. It's your fortune. It's where the world is heading. So if you want to be part of the new world, part of the evolution, do not be judges in a seat that is hollow. Put on your covering. Put on your new costume. Put on the coat of many colors. Put on the rainbow. Then your soul is complete. Enclosed circle. Not half full anymore. Not half of a person looking. I'm seeing a magnet. Your soul is a magnet. It's a rod of iron. And when other people's rods came into your arc, your chest, their magnet would suck out all of the precious metals and steal everything from you. Okay? You're closing your circuit. You're closing your circuit. This is a magnetic operation on its own now. Some kind of circuit. Electromagnetic circuit here that's complete on its own, spinning now, putting a spin on everything, making everything beautiful, making everything sharper, clearer, in tune, beautiful, vibrant colors, okay? Full circumspect vision from every angle is what it means. So this is a principle of the new earth. You will not get there if you continue to judge other people's behaviors, especially for some reason, especially the up and coming generations. Maybe it's those that we have the most judgment for. I don't know, because that is not my experience at all. There's something coming in this next generation, and you will be part of it. In fact, you will lead the way because you have wisdom. This is what I'm seeing. You have gray hair, and I'm seeing a bunch of things. Your wisdom is respected. If it's the right wisdom, if it's in tune with the truth. Do you remember that our rainbow had a gray hoarfrost over it? Hoar means gray. Gray hoarfrost. It's elder hair, white hair, wisdom. Ripe, ripe, ripe corn. White hair coming out. White hair coming out. So if you are an elder, okay, of this generation, right, us older ones, I know I'm speaking to a lot of my age people here. If you are an elder, you can be respected by the younger generations as long as you return the respect and as long as you see the beauty in what they are doing and do not judge it, okay? Then they're going to see, oh, they know who I am, they understand, and they are older and wiser. And this is a reciprocal relationship then, okay? That's it. That's it. It's long enough. I will see you guys soon. Thank you so much for watching. If you like these videos, subscribe, please, and or join our community. We go into a lot more depth. We are literally unraveling the mysteries of the universe, and it's a beautiful thing. I will see you soon.